Yeah.
Like if I took you for a date, something like that. Eh?
Did you catch that? Did you hear that?
Yeah.
Sorry.
Builder. So even today I still go to some of the, you know, like what they used to study in the 50s, and it was very traditional architecture,
yes,
and all that. I think I got that huge interest from him, yeah.
Okay.
You know, to get into building. Or after I joined high school, I took keen interest in drawing. So, okay, you know, when you do your choice of subjects, you could choose either agriculture, or you could choose drawing and design, you could choose commerce. So I quickly knew that I wanted, you know, just to be involved in drawings and stuff. So that's why this, in fact, is the biggest project I've worked on so far. Okay. I have worked on other malls. Like I was working on the Junction Shopping Center, worked on Nyali Mall. It's always a long journey before you reach here. It takes, let's say, 2 years of work. Maybe the first 1 year you're doing your concepts and exploring different, you know, permutations of what you can do with the place. Because the thing about, you know, like the use of land, like what we have here, you decide, is a shopping mall the most suited thing to do here? A conference facility, is it, do you need to have offices, do you need to have a hotel, all those things. So yeah, so there has to be some sort of study done on what the market needs, and then now that has to influence what you do here. All these things, they have to be brought together, and from that now you end up with a product of what you have right now. Yeah. The current hub is like a village concept to it. Eh? So what we have is that we have these different blocks within the development, and they are all unified by these squares or public spaces.
Okay.
Which, you know, and these, you know, different buildings, houses, different functions. You know, you'll have one building is like a sort of a banking hub, the other one houses the entertainment area, the other one is a wellness center or a, you know, or a health club. And all these are joined together by a series of streets and squares and bridges, which I think is very nice, because the concept of Karen, even from the past, was this, you know, this meeting area. Like if you go like to the Karen shopping center, you find the original Karen shopping center.
Yes.
Was a sort of a market square. Mm. And then everything is, you know, arranged around that. It's approximately 20 acres.
Wow.
The building itself, the gross built area is, yeah, in excess of 60,000 square meters. And the lettable area for the shops is about 33,000 square meters. You could say it's twice the size of the Junction. It's a hub, it's a convergence point for people to come and shop and be entertained, and, you know, and we've managed to work out everything through these streets and squares, which lead you to this block which houses this function, you know,
okay,
to the lake, to the, you know, to the entry. And yeah, I think that has been, in my view, the biggest achievement that we've made with the design of this project.
Yeah. Shall we take a walk?
Yeah, sure. A building like this probably will not be suited if you're doing it in the CBD, you know.
Yeah.
So we just thought that because this is Karen, then this is more suited for this kind of architecture. The restaurants will be here, so it will be nicely landscaped. So once the completion has been, you know, is done for this project, you'll have now a lot of activity here and interest, because you have people sitting in the restaurants there, you have an escalator going up there. So when you're here, you can see, oh, that's the escalator there, that's another escalator there, that's a, you know, the banks are on the top floor there. The key highlight of a restaurant is to provide, you know, if it's a restaurant which has opportunity to have external seating area, then that area must have or must be of interest, you know. So what we have here is that the people who are sitting here, they are in a double volume area, which, you know, just means that what you're like going to have here, you see like that feeling here, we're going to have nice big chandeliers coming down and creating more richness to the space. And then these people, they can flow out into the piazza, you know. Yeah. So if you're going to have these restaurants with these terraces, then you needed to have all the water feature came in very, you know, was quite key because it now increased the quality of the space, yeah? Mm. The weather that we have in Kenya, we didn't, you know, where the temperature extremes, you know, is not like, you know, very variant, you know. That means that all these open spaces are usable at all times of the year, you know. So we thought that here's a chance, instead of doing like what you've done or what you've seen in the past, like very closed food courts, let's just have like all these areas are open to the, you know, the open areas, open to walkways, open to the lake, open to the front terraces. I think that just captures the whole style of living that you'd find in the current, you know, in the current area. When you're in this lake area, you can hear the waterfall. There's a bridge just next to it, so you can go there and halfway take a picture or take a picnic with your family. I always think that, like, for instance, in this country, you know, we're facing challenges with a lot of, you know, the people living in slums and all that. My proudest thing would be, you know, like, if there could be just local solutions found to sort of solve all these problems. And maybe based on that, I also think that when you come and you're building in a place, you must come there and look at your environment very closely and try to do a building that fits within that environment, that probably has the least impact on that environment. And that is why in this project we have done a very low-key development, improve on that environment by having an artificial lake. So, you know, that means you're creating a sort of a small ecosystem there, you know, the lake will have fish and, you know, plant more trees where we've cut, you know. So I think that has been very key. Yeah. You have to follow your passion. If you really want to become an architect, then you have to be prepared to work hard for it and have passion in what you do. So you have to tell yourself when you are doing this project, is this the best I could do? And there are many times you do something and you're like, no, this is not good enough. And you just have a feeling, oh, this is, and maybe that will make you spend more time on it, trying to think, no, this is a solution, but this is not the perfect solution. This is not the ideal solution. So you have then to tell yourself every time you're doing something, is this the best I could have done?